Hi, it's Jamie with Jamie's Arts a la Carte. Thank you very much for joining me. I have a fun project planned for us today. I hope this video inspires you to create something of your own. If you would, hit the like button and share the video with your friends. That helps me to grow this channel and to continue to bring you new projects. If you haven't subscribed yet, would you please consider subscribing? And if you have, thank you very much. Well, we have a lot to do, so let's get to it. All right, we got a pile of stuff everywhere. So I want to make a winter wreath. So I want to do the poof style. I just like that. It doesn't fray as bad. I've got beautiful ribbon from the Dollar Tree. Another little of that. Some with snowflakes. I've got these little wooden slides. Sleds. And then some ice skates. I've got some ribbon that's not from the Dollar Tree. All right, just to finish it off. So, and I've even got this. I think I'm going to make my own sign. Something simple like let it snow on this pretty glitter little canvas. All right, so those are that's the thought that I have. So I want to start by painting because we have to let it dry. I'm always saying we have to let it dry, but we have to let it dry. So we'll put those over here and want these out. So we'll paint our little items. So I have a couple ideas what I want to do with those. And then we'll cut our pipe cleaners. Alright, so this should be a fun one. Alright, we have a lot to do. Let's get to it. Alright, so let's start by cutting our drop cloth, i.e. our plastic bag. Not going to cut these apart just yet. I'll probably untie them as opposed to cutting them. Ooh, look at that. I'm going to have to go too deep. I have an idea. I'm not sure if it's going to work just yet. But I'm thinking I might make it dangle at the bottom with these skates. We'll see if that works. Okay. So let's go ahead and just untie this. Not sure if it'll take more than one coat being raw wood. We're about to find out. I want to do like just a like a whitewash on them, so we'll see if that helps with only needing one coat. All right, let's get to painting. We've got several brushes. We're going to start with a big one. I'm going to start with light blue here. And then I'm going to start with brown, and then I want to do a dry brush blue over it to bring it back to that winter theme. There's that one. Here, let's try. Alright, so now let's get our first coat on these. I think I'm going to do, this is usually like a silver metal, so we'll do blue here. Over and where it touched plastic, go ahead and just give it, smooth it out. Okay, something like that. Know what I'm gonna say. We have to let it dry. Those are almost, I'll go dig out the paint. We might sure. Start on those. Let's make sure this is cleaned off. Let's start with the easy part. I think that's super cute. Didn't mess up the back, so that's good. Then we'll come in and put some dots right in there. That'll look cute. I'm gonna decide how I'm gonna fix this glue thing. Thank you.
Alright. Get the first coat on this one. There they are. That's the white. And I'm going to go over these three actually one more time. Let's go back over any white spots. All right, let's see how that dries. So I went and dug out my silver paint, metallic. So I'm going to put that down here, and then for the lace holes. And I think we'll call that quits at that point. Get my brush cleaned out. Literally squeeze it right. Oh, gotta shake it. That was all fluff right there. Better. Let's mix this up. All right. See what this is going to look like. It's kind of thin, but that's okay. It means the blue will kind of show through. It's kind of, sort of, but not really. Well, yes, really, but not in an overpowering way. Ooh, it's very loose. Look at that. I have to fix that. Let's see if I can get that to go thicker. That's a little too thin. Thank you. right. Shoot, doggies. All right, we're gonna let those dry. Gonna go clean our paintbrushes. I think we're done with paint. Oh, before we clean our paintbrushes, we wanted to put a blue. Do we still want to put a blue dry on there? I might do just another brown before I put all my paints away. Maybe just one more brown. Everything is dry. We have it setting over here to the side. It came out good. Pleased with how they came out. So now it's time to start building this wreath. So I have this frame. It came from Dollar Tree, so it's a 14 inch. And we're going to start cutting our pipe cleaners. I just do them in half, and if they're all like I used that on something and I said nope, that's okay, those work perfectly fine. So got my cutters and I'm just going to fold them in half. They don't have to be perfect, close is good. Pine cones. Take them off first. Those will come in handy somewhere, some point. One more over here. See, that's not very bendable, so I'm going to cut all of these off. It doesn't do me any good if I can't bend it. Getting as close to that base as I can. See something. Can those? Oh, there's another pine cone. Let's get rid of this. Let's put our pieces there. Get that out of the way. Thank you. might be more than we need for this project, but it helps to get it disassembled and out of the way. And I honestly don't remember where it came from, but there you go. I'm going to actually throw that away, y'all. That doesn't happen too often, but there it goes. All right. Let's get our little fluff up. Shirt. Okay. These all look dry. Yeah, we have this little glue strings everywhere. It's okay. You'll never see it. So, there it is. There's our front. So now, I think what I want to do is I want to start with the deco mesh. And let that be the base. So I have three. I have four. I have white. Not sure if I'm going to use those or not. Have them if I need them. Let's see how far we go with this. I'm not going to do, normally I do like a 10 or a 12, 10, 11, 12 poof. I think I'm going to pull that back because I put that extra row in here. I wanted it super full. So, so basically, I want to start here. So if I went 10, that'd be way over here. So let's see. If I'm on 8, 10, 10. Bring it back to here. Let's try 1. Let's see where we want it to be. So I'm going to have a good amount of tail. I'm going to poke it underneath. I'm going to bring it up and I'm going to give it a good twist. And I'm going to put it here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It needs to go over to here. Let's do that. Let's do 6. So that means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm going to go to 14. Okay. You know, I don't want to think about it. I just want to do the same thing and see what it looks like. I pull that over to 8. I'm going to go back to 14. I'm going to go to the next one on the inside ring. I'm going to give it a good twist. And I see how it already starts to... And they just do that. That's why I do the poof. I used to roll them. They were very aggravating. Okay. Thank you. stuff this back behind. Pull it. Give it a little bit, but we'll cut this thing off here. Okay, I think we're not going to open these. That'd be perfect for another project. So now we have, oh, this is pretty, right? So I have two of those, which now we know two will do this. And I have three with the snowflakes. So I think I want to put this on first. Tuck that to the back. And there is that color. Alright. I think that worked well. Alright, let's see what this is like now. I've used this in the past also. Big fires on first. All and they can, we can have a couple dangle or in here. That's not sure. Alright, I think I do want to fluff only because once I start putting things on there, I'm not going to be able to fluff. So let's rethink that. Looking for places that look thin because I've got enough product on here. It's just like you gotta fluff it. Okay, so that's what it looks like so far. So now. Put another one down here. Let's see. Get away with not using a pipe cleaner. Thank you. to see if we want to use any of these. It's a few of our chenilles. Let's drag. Finishes it off, doesn't it? Alright, okay. I'm making my glue sticks. Yes, they are from the Dollar Tree. Oops. Well, there it is. This is sort of a different kind of wreath for me, although I like how it came out. All right, well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. It kind of was a different one, but I hope you liked it. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope it inspires you to create something of your own. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, would you please consider subscribing? And well, until next time, happy crafting!